Today, New York.
Dr. Philip Orton, maritime research scientist at the Stevens Institute. Nice to have you back on Good Day, New York. Where are the floodwaters right now? What are you seeing? What information are you getting?
Well, we're seeing it. They're getting close to the Irene flood levels. On the Jersey Shore, they're higher. Around Manhattan and Newark and these areas, they're a little bit lower. But I think this is a real clue. If people look at where the floodwaters are now, then they're going to see something from 3 to 9 feet higher than that.
Wow.
Tonight. So it's very severe flooding. And I'm saying 9 feet sort of on the conservative high end, but 3 is also a conservative low end estimate.
A lot of people in the area are used to street flooding. Water backs up, drains are clogged with leaves. The type of flooding we're talking about, seawater, is certainly much more complicated to recover from. Tell us about that, the effects of seawater once this starts coming into basements.
Yeah, well, if there's anything electrical, like with Con Ed's systems underground, they're very concerned about that. And so seawater can corrode things a lot more. And so it's nearly pure seawater. It's a mix of some rainwater also, but it can really corrode things a lot more, especially metal objects.
I know we've been talking about Battery Park and some of the other low-lying areas. What are you hearing about Hoboken, New Jersey?
Yeah, Hoboken is really vulnerable because it's the back of Hoboken's not much above sea level, if at all, and it's a little bit more of a bowl. It's one of our few areas that has a New Orleans type problem. It's not as deep as low as New Orleans, but it's very low and it can hold water, and it's hard. It could get end up holding maybe 8 feet of water or 10 feet of water, you know, roughly at the back.
Yeah, the most densely populated area is right here in Manhattan and throughout the five boroughs. Do you see large sections of our city going off the grid, or do you think we're going to be able to withstand these floodwaters and keep power on for most of the city?
I think there's a good chance that large areas will go off the grid. If we get another 6 feet of sea level in the next high tide, then it's going to, I think it's going to go over the plywood they put over the subway doors. The subways are going to get flooded. There's a good chance of that now. And Con Edison probably is also not ready for it. We're going to have, and this one thing I want to stress is this isn't like rain flooding. This is an ocean of water coming into your basement, apartment, or, you know, people need to get to high ground if they're anywhere near any of the flood zones. The zone A is going to be quite likely under 6 feet of water.
This is Battery Park right now. This is zone A, right?
Yeah.
And it's already been breached.
Yep. And so we can expect three, and on the high end, if this is getting stronger as it makes landfall like we see, it might even be 9 feet more than what that shows.
Doctor, distinguish this year from last year, because we've already seen people on camera this morning say, you know what, I rode out Irene, I was fine, and I'm going to ride out this one, and I'm going to be fine. What is the difference meteorologically or with respect to this surge that makes this system significantly more dangerous than what we saw a year ago?
It's also a very big system that's coming in for a long time and blowing onshore winds for a long time, but this one's a lot stronger winds that we can expect tonight. Hmm. So that's a big factor, I would say. And also the waves are larger, so they're going to erode away beaches. One sort of metaphor for this is this morning the beaches are getting sort of like a boxer. They're getting softened up. And this evening, if the beaches and dunes are already eroded, then the surge is going to get that much higher.
Okay, Dr. Philip Orton, maritime research scientist, thank you so much for being with us this morning. Appreciate that information. We're already seeing flooding in the area.